by which new legal principles are evolved to upgrade existing law. Judicial activism, of course, is judgment law. And why would we want to engage in judicial activism? The purpose is to bring the law in conformity with the current needs or expectations of society. And, you know, many times, of course, expectations and current needs are represented in progressive constitutions as well as universally accepted human rights norms and values. So to me, that is judicial activism. Now, I did talk about mainstream agenda in our activities as criminal justice actors. Any discussion of the treatment of women in the criminal justice system calls for an understanding of gender. And this is important, whether the women are being processed in the system as offenders, like the women I dealt with during my research for the book that Ben has referred to, or women as victims, or women merely as witnesses in a criminal justice system. And why? Why would you want to discuss issues of gender? It's because an appreciation of gender gives us insight into how to develop a more robust understanding of justice. That's why you must understand what gender is. But I think all of us know that gender deals with what society expects of women and of course men. But socially constructed roles or gender roles are often a result of gender bias. Many of the gender roles we talk about are based on stereotypical beliefs rather than an independent evaluation of what somebody's experience is or what somebody's ability is. Now that I have a little more time, let me tell you this. We have many times talked about what is expected of a woman, and then somebody goes and writes, natural, caregiver. And then we are told about all these roles. Actually, I'm not interested in those roles as an individual. But because I'm a woman, you all assume that I love to cook. I don't. So this is based on an evaluation of what people think I'm interested in. But anyway, based on, I think we must know that bias is mental, but discrimination is action. So bias results into discrimination. But we must remember that as actors in the criminal justice system, we deal with the consequences of people's conduct when they come before us as offenders. So certainly understanding gender and its connotations and the its dynamics is important. And I just want to ask, do social expectations play a role in how we as judges interpret and deal with people's conduct? But even more, if you say, do the expectations play a role? Should these expectations actually play a role when we are engaged with people's conduct as adjudicators? And then of course for the prosecutors, a prosecutor is guided by these values as they decide whether to prosecute a case or not, even when they zero on what offense to judge. I think these are issues we should talk about. Then we must also know that bias and discrimination, which I've already talked about, can be direct, but it can also be indirect discrimination. So we must learn to recognize gender bias in statutory law as well as in practice. But of course, we must also learn to recognize gender bias in judgment law, so that perhaps we engage in judicial activism even when there are precedents, and we depart from those precedents using the progressive constitutions that we now have on the African continent, but also, of course, on the international